morning and welcome to Immaculate Conception Church. Please silence all cell phones and other mobile devices at this time. This morning we celebrate the memorial of St. Catherine of Siena, and this mass is being celebrated for Steve Lowinger. Please stand.
David, son of Jesse, a man
throughout my name shall his horn be exalted. He shall save me. You are my Father, my God, the rock, my Savior.
For our God is saved, the goodness of the Lord.
Blessed be God who reveals me not, my prayer or his kindness. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Dear boys and girls, brothers and sisters in Christ, we have a wonderful opportunity this morning to reflect upon God's holy word. In particular, there was a word that Father Bruno repeated a couple of times within the gospel. Did you hear there was a phrase that Jesus said one word twice at the beginning and then twice at the end of the gospel? Do you recall what word was that? It's a word we often say at the close of a prayer. Happen to hear what word was said there? Yes. Amen. That's right. It's the word that I always try to end my homilies with too. Amen. Now, what do you know in your different classes or studies or life of prayer? Do you know what the word amen means, more or less? Yes. I believe. Yes, indeed. I believe too. You believe. We all believe. Yes. You're right. It comes from the Hebrew. It's a word which means affirmative or agree or I believe. Yes, so Jesus was sharing with his friends, the disciples, after he had washed their feet there at the Last Supper, he was saying, amen, amen, I believe this. He was repeating it because it had so much significance. Very good. So have you ever heard different things repeated over and over, maybe from your parents or your teachers, if something is important? Has that ever happened to you? You have? Oh, good. Anyone care to share an experience of that happening? Nobody. All right. Oh, yes, please, Joseph. Yes, indeed. Thank you for that awesome example. That happened to me growing up as well. So Mom or Dad said, go clean your room. And then they said it again, go clean your room. So Joseph knew that meant he needed to go and clean his room. Well said, you're right. And that does happen to us, you're right. Perfect, thank you for that example. Yes. This is one simple word that's been repeated to her. No, you're right. Sometimes, yes, our family members, friends, teachers, others, they will say no. And ultimately, behind every no, there's a greater yes. We're saying yes to freedom. We're saying yes to the fullness of living in the truth, of choosing good things, of no for the moment. So again, the question I would get, or a response when I hear no growing up is, you know, can I have an extra piece of cake or an extra lemon bar? And my parents would say no. So I can resonate with you there. Anybody else, an experience you have from your own life's journey? Yes, our friend over here, you've had your hand up for a little bit. Yes. Put your laundry away. Oh, I've heard that one too. Father Bruno on occasion, he says, Father James, put your laundry away. That sometimes happens. That's true. You're right. Sometimes we need those reminders. So Jesus, again, reminding his disciples about the importance of who he was and who he is, who he always will be. Yes, maybe another example. Fold your clothes. Again, it's something that happens after you get your laundry done. It's washed. Then you gotta fold it. Good point, thank you. Yes? Clean the dishes. So a lot of these are kind of domestic duties, different things that we're called to do at home, you're right. So clean the dishes, do the dishes, fold your clothes, get your laundry done, yes. Do your hair, that's right, you wanna look nice and spiffy, and you do today, so kudos to you, you can tell mom and dad you did your hair, well done. Yes, yes, that's right. And then I say to you, you're all doing great today, yes. Eat your dinner. They have to repeat that to you? Your parents, your siblings, or others? Your dad does, okay. Well, that's good, because he knows that when you eat your food, you get nice and strong and you continue to grow. That's a good thing to share. And he says you have to be good, otherwise you can't go to Lake Superior tomorrow. Sometimes we need that extra incentive. And Jesus encouraged his disciples, talking about the kingdom of heaven as an extra incentive. So that's almost like the Lake Superior of the heavenly realm. So yes, thank you. Do your homework. That's a really appropriate one. Any teachers ever tell your students that? Maybe time and time again, yes. That's a good one. Thank you, Jordan. Yes. Cook. Your parents just hand you different pots and pans and food and say, cook? Really? Wow, well, they're teaching you responsibility. That's a good thing in your life to be able to know how to cook, and some of you how to clean, and then how to do your laundry. Wow, you guys are very responsible. I'm so proud of you guys. Yes? Be smarter than everything? Okay, well, you're right. God wants us to use our minds so we have that intelligence. Like he is. Okay, well, maybe there's a lesson that your teacher and family could say, be humble too. But you're right, but we do want to use our brain. So thank you for that. Yes, we do want to use that intelligence God has given to us. Yes. Wake up. Oh my goodness. For any of the prisoners here, they know that that's one that I probably should hear every day, over and over again, so that I make it to Mass on time. You're right. So true. We need that repetition for us, so that it really settles in. Thank you. Yes? Make your bed. Yeah, that's right. If you're there and you just wake up, you gotta pull the sheets back and make sure it's all in place. Yes. What's that? No. This one, yeah, I'm guessing some of the parents in the congregation or grandparents, stop doing your electronics. That's right. Get off your iPad. Get off the computer. Get out in the real world. Yes. Those are all things that we need to hear every now and again, including Father Bruno and I. Yes. Mom always says she has to cook for her brother. Well, that's very kind of you. That's a good gift that you offer for your brother. Wonderful. Boys and girls, you offered some fantastic examples. We got one more here. Mom says take out the trash. That's right. That happens a lot to me as well. I can totally understand where you're coming from, and that's important because otherwise the trash builds up in the house. It gets all stinky. You don't want that to happen, so you gotta take the trash out. Sometimes we gotta hear that message more than once. So again, Jesus repeating the words of amen, amen, emphasizing the importance of what he was sharing with his friend the Last Supper. One more example here with our buddy with the spiffy here. Yes. Oh, amen, amen, I say to you, make sure you pray every day. Yes, indeed, that is what I say. Pray every day just to make it through the day. Yes, you are right. That is so true. Thank you. You're right. We are called to pray on a daily basis. That is ultimately how we make that connection with God and those around us. We grow in that friendship with the Lord, continue to experience his goodness, his grace, and mercy, that ultimately after our journeys here on earth, we'll be able to join all of those friends in the heavenly kingdom, including St. Catherine of Siena, who prayed every day. We'll be able to join God there in the heavenly kingdom to pray there forever and ever. Amen. Amen. I say to you, let us stand and pray. We'll offer up our heartfelt prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. Those who will be reading our prayers, the faithful, can come forward at this time. We believe that God indeed hears every prayer that we offer to him on a daily basis. And we want to lift up all of those needs of our faith community here at Immaculate Conception, all of those needs from our families and friends, all of our teachers, that God would continue to help us in our time of need.
Suffering, the homeless and the unemployed, and anyone in any kind of distress, that they may experience the healing presence of God through those who pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for each of us, may we offer our own gifts and talents to each other, remembering that each of us is created in God's image. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
all of us at Immaculate Conception School, that we may continue to be positively powered and strive to uphold our core values, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For all of the faithfully departed, especially Steve, Lauren, Gert, for whom this mask is being offered, may they be purified of sin and share the glory of eternal joy with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and praise for the goodness of your Son, Jesus. He who was raised up on the third day to raise us to new life. In this Easter season, continue to send forth your Holy Spirit, that we ourselves would pray and do the dishes and clean our laundry and do all of those individual tasks, including our homework, that we would grow in using the gifts you have given us for your glory. We make all of our prayers through Christ our Lord. I invite you to please stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of his name.
Accept, O Lord, the saving sacrifice we offer in commemoration of Saint Catherine, so that instructed by her teaching, we may give ever more fervent thanks to you, the one true God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To very gently use those kneelers in front of you to kneel at this time. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, and Chris, our sister, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. light of your face, have mercy on us, how we pray. That with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We walk in the light as God is in the light, then we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of his Son Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. Alleluia. invite you to please be seated for a few moments. It's been our custom on the last Thursday of each month to offer a Halo Award for those saints in training for the students and some of our staff here at Immaculate Conception. So we've got our middle school teacher, Ms. Tonya Nato, who will be making those presentations for this morning. So a nice icy welcome for Ms. Tonya Nato.
This month is actually our final Halo Award. It is our final Saintly Service Awards for the year. So first of all, I want to give a huge congratulations to any of you who have won in the past, and a huge thank you to the staff and to the students who have really put this forth in our classroom and in our school. We can see the difference that it's made, so thank you to all of you who have participated this year. So for our final month, we have St. Francis of Assisi, which is be the change that you wish to see. So that means putting on that act of Christ every morning. That means trusting in faith when doing impossible tasks. It means letting our actions reflect God's grace. Even if in the past, not all of your actions reflected that, it's making those changes to have a better future and walking with God along the way. So first we will start with our Saintly Service Awards. We'll go top to bottom, as usual. Our first St. Francis of Assisi Saintly Service Award is granted to 7th grader Jezebel Riera Igoro. And next, what a surprise, we have a pick from our wonderful 5th grade class, Simone Schuler. Okay, congratulations to our Saintly Service kids. Good job. So for our last Halo Award, we really wanted to hit a home run. We really wanted to make something special happen. And I think the team, the Saintly Service team and I, thank you to Mr. Haig, Mrs. Gulikowski, Mrs. Falls, and Mrs. Mona, of course, always offers her insight. I think we picked something really special for this last one. And St. Francis of Assisi has a quote that sort of stuck out to me. And it says, start by doing what's necessary, then what's possible. And suddenly you're doing the impossible. And for many years, there has been this certain light that has been the necessary guide to change our classrooms, to change our school community. This light has illuminated the way for our school and for our church to step out of sort of a place of darkness and to really bring us to a place where we can truly live the Gospels in any task, whether it's in the classroom, staff meetings, school events, just little things that make a huge difference. So this light starts with what's necessary for our school, you know, the kids, families, and eventually moves to what's possible, like revamping our campus, reaching out to former alumni or friends. And what's amazing, boys and girls, is that these tasks are only made possible by the grace of God, working through not one, but two amazing saints of our own. Two people who have made a difference in every life that has walked through these doors and created really a place to call home, which is really special. So our final Halo Award goes to two people who have achieved the wonderfully impossible, and that is Roger and Jane Bona.
Thank all of you for this award, and if indeed I am worthy of it, I think the word to describe it would be motivation. You, each and every one of you out here, motivate me. When I'm in the parking lot in the morning and I see the doors open and the kids come running out because they want to be in the school, that's motivation for me. And I had a woman tell me this morning, Queenie is her name, I don't know her exact name, but she always wears this Queenie shirt. She said, the world needs what we offer. And I thought, whoa. So very thankful for that. But again, when I see the growth in you, that inspires me. What can I do? Because I was in your spot at one time. And thankful for the people that motivated me. So again, thank you for your motivation. If I respond to that, all the better.
Saints in Training, the Halo Award winners. You know, very fitting, the homily was about the repetition of words we hear. So today was bona bona, so there you go. And actually from Latin, the word bona means good. So there you go, it was very, very good. We're grateful to God for, again, everyone here, we're all saints in training. We're all doing what we can to build up God's kingdom. With that, together, let us stand and pray. We have been fed, O Lord, confer eternal life upon us, as even in this world it nourished the life of Saint Catherine, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So good to pray with all of you this morning, a very special day indeed. Congratulations again to you, Mrs. Bona and Mr. Bona, for the great work you're doing, and all of you kids, thank you for your words of wisdom, your insights, and sharing from your own experiences from home life, even as your parents repeat those different things again. It's because they love you, they care for you, your teachers as well. When they tell you again and again to do your homework, to be respectful, to do those good things, it's because, again, they see the best in you. They see the capacity you have for ongoing growth. So keep it up. Great job to our lectors, our readers, those who help with the prayers of the faithful. Thank you to Father Bruno for this morning, for your presence as always. For Gina, thank you so much for helping to lead us in songs, our cantor. For Dr. Ray, our director of music and liturgy, thank you very much. To the ever wonderful Sandy Sechek, Miss Sandy, I think she's over in the sacristy helping out. Thank you to you for helping get everything all set. And hopefully all have a beautiful and blessed rest of this day. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord.